Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. Oh, hey, look, a pizza bagel. Wait a minute, that's Cthulhu under there. Tricky, tricky. There's a lot that our bodies do that most of us never have to think about. Blinking, breathing, heart beating, aging. Oh no, are you thinking about that stuff? I'm sorry. But for some people, that last one that I mentioned isn't so easy, due to certain medical conditions that make people age slower or not at all. In the back of your head, at the base of your skull, is a pea-sized organ called the pituitary gland. It produces several hormones that control your thyroid activity and body temperature, among other things. One of these hormones is the growth hormone, or somatotropin, whose primary role is to promote growth in children. It's also responsible for the maintenance of tissues and organs throughout adulthood. It's pretty important. It's working so hard. I mean, look at it go. One out of every 4,000 to 10,000 children born have a growth hormone deficiency, meaning their pituitary gland doesn't produce enough growth hormone. While these children will typically be normal size at birth, they don't physically age like their peers. They may be shorter with a rounder, younger-looking face because the growth of their facial and long bones is delayed. They also may retain their baby fat around their abdomen and have delayed tooth development. It's typically diagnosed during major developmental periods after they miss a usual growth spurt or puberty milestones. Because of this, many teenagers with growth hormone deficiency suffer from low self-esteem. In children, growth hormone deficiency can be caused by either genetic mutations or due to brain damage while the fetus is still developing. It can also be acquired after birth due to a brain injury, tumor, infection, or radiation therapy, in which case it is called acquired growth hormone deficiency. Adults with AGHD typically have high levels of cholesterol and fats in their blood due to metabolism changes, and are at higher risk of heart disease. Treatment involves daily injections of synthetic growth hormone. For congenital cases, these injections typically only last until puberty, when their bodies naturally begin to develop enough of the hormone on their own, but can also continue into adulthood if needed. Growth hormone therapy is also used for a number of other conditions associated with inadequate growth, such as Turner syndrome and Prader-Willi syndrome. But beyond these disorders, there is a condition so rare, it's only been observed in a handful of individuals. This condition, recently named neotenic complex syndrome, results in an extreme developmental delay, where individuals are stunted both physically and mentally. One such woman died at the age of 20 years old, weighing just 16 pounds, with the mental capacity of a 2-year-old. While they appear to be frozen in time, people with the condition are actually aging at a much, much slower rate, and are often unable to walk, eat, and speak. While researchers are still looking for the exact cause, they believe it's due to genetic mutations occurring in the sperm or egg cells, or in the fertilized egg, called de novo mutations. Though, because only an extremely small number of people have this syndrome, limiting the amount of available data, it's difficult to know for sure. Scientists hope that by discerning the root cause, in addition to helping those with neotenic complex syndrome, they will one day be able to develop drugs that regulate aging. So are there any other conditions you'd like me to explore? Let me know now in the comment section below. We're taking suggestions for future videos. If you want to know why these babies are so muscular, but completely healthy, check out this video. And found that at 4.5 years old, the size of his quadriceps was over 7 standard deviations above the average for his age. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.